Chapter 8, The Impact Triangle, Maximizing Efficiency, Financial Sustainability, and Scale by Gloria Lee. Every social entrepreneur must be able to address these three dimensions simultaneously to maximize the impact of their organization. Notice, and I would like to emphasize the word simultaneously. Each of these is difficult to achieve on its own. It can also be stressful, requiring complex trade-offs and constant risk management. Sometimes organizations will succeed at one, but fail at another. As organizations mature, the challenges of each area change. Addressing each area increases the current and potential positive benefits of the organization. Let us try to define these words in the context of social innovation. Every social welfare organization is intended to address a specific social problem like housing the homeless, decreasing carbon emissions, closing the gap in education, increasing legitimate rights for the oppressed minority, bringing tidiness to a community, protecting endangered species, or one of numerous other commendable objectives. An organization's efficacy is how well it serves its intended recipient or changes conditions in its chosen field. Social change organizations need resources to operate. Dollars, talent, supplies. Sustainability describes an organization's ability to gather the resources it needs to do its work. Financial sustainability is important, regardless of whether the organization is a for-profit organization, a corporation, a non-profit public organization. This is important even if the organization relies heavily on volunteer work. Sustainability also means that the organization has the necessary resources to cover its administrative work and resource acquisition functions. Almost all social change organizations strive to grow, to benefit more individuals, more communities, and more areas of concern. It requires scalability, the ability to increase an organization's social benefit through expansion, replication, or extension. The ideas in this chapter will be useful to prospective and current social entrepreneurs, students with an interest in social enterprise, board members of mission-focused organizations, and donors. Let's get more into details. So, how do we increase the efficiency of our social organization? Highly effective organizations usually have these three things: a clear theory of change, an aligned operating model, and a discipline to measure progress and continuously improve. A clear theory of change. The theory of change is a crucial tool for organizations aiming to create societal impact. It helps stakeholders understand the organization's goals and how they will be achieved. However, there are challenges in developing a theory of change, such as deciding on the level of detail and complexity. Some prefer a linear sequential format, while others want it to include various factors and consequences. Well, a theory of change should articulate the rationale for the goal and process. There is a risk of oversimplification or complexity. Some authors may struggle to find the right balance, leading to unclear or overly complicated theories. Hyperlinks can be a useful tool to provide additional details and explanations without cluttering the main document. Overall, creating a theory of change requires careful consideration and communication with all stakeholders. It is essential to strike a balance between clarity and thoroughness to ensure that the theory effectively guides the organization towards the desired outcomes. An aligned operating model. Operating models in social impact organizations are essential for ensuring alignment and achieving organizational goals. While there is a lack of enough literature on this topic, it is crucial for success. This is often just as important as a well-crafted theory of change. Jim Collins and Jerry Porras emphasize the importance of alignment in their book, Built to Last. Private sector frameworks such as McKinsey's 7S framework or Bain's operating model framework can be applied to social organizations to understand their inner workings. Developing an operating model that aligns internally and externally is necessary for maximizing efficacy and scaling impact. For example, a healthcare organization may have a successful treatment, but without the necessary support systems and alignment with the external context, it cannot achieve its mission. Adapting the operating model to changing conditions or new opportunities is also crucial for success, as seen in the example of Fresh Lifeline for Youth, creating a new program in response to a new law. Fresh Lifelines is an organization which helps prevent the juvenile incarceration through legal education and mentoring. A robust, well-integrated approach to measuring progress. Social impact organizations must continuously assess the effectiveness of their work to gain support, make adjustments, and motivate staff. Initially, organizations may use anecdotal evidence, participant surveys, and efficacy data to demonstrate their impact. Some organizations eventually seek validation from third-party evaluators to secure funding and enable growth. Some may even conduct randomized controlled trials to prove efficacy. However, simply proving efficacy does not guarantee growth, as political opposition and ineffective solutions can hinder progress. For example, charter management organizations have shown significant positive effects on student performance, yet opposition has limited their expansion. Similarly, a widely adopted program for teaching English language arts was based on flawed methodologies, contributing to poor literacy rates in schools. Ultimately, understanding why interventions are effective and evaluating efficacy in different contexts over time are essential for social sector organizations. Proof of efficacy sets social organizations apart from private corporations. but it does not always guarantee opportunity for growth and success. Increasing sustainability. Every organization needs resources to do its work, and social sector organizations are no exception. People, whether volunteers, employees, or contractors, need to be recruited, supported, and retained. The stuff that is essential to the organization's work, whether books, technology, land, medical equipment, or other things, must be procured. Whatever the mission an organization needs to ensure that the resources that come in are at least as much as the resources expended in doing the work. Just like any business, a social impact organization needs to identify a viable revenue model, manage costs, and ensure sufficient cash flow. Let's talk about the viable revenue model. Developing a financially sustainable model is crucial for social sector organizations. Social entrepreneurs have a variety of options for achieving financial sustainability, but each potential source of funds requires different capabilities, organizational characteristics, and risks. Many social entrepreneurs rely on philanthropic donations as their main source of funds, with some impact organizations receiving smaller donations from individuals. Various strategies, such as teaching in churches and alumni class gift committees in colleges, are used to encourage charitable giving. Social media campaigns like ALS Ice Bucket Challenge have successfully raised millions of dollars for causes. Foundations play a significant role in charitable giving, with private foundations typically established by high net worth individuals and families. However, there is often reluctance among foundations to adequately fund administrative expenses, leading to stress for social entrepreneurs in securing donations. Examples like Build, which teaches entrepreneurship to young people, illustrate the challenges of fundraising. Despite these challenges, charitable giving plays a vital role in supporting various causes and organizations. Over the past two decades, more social impact organizations have been adopting an earned revenue model to secure income through product sales, service fees, or contracts. This monetizes their impact, with some organizations directly deriving revenue from their core social activities. For example, Rubicon Bakery sells baked goods produced during worker training, and BRAC in Bangladesh uses earned revenue from microfinance lending to reduce poverty. To understanding the cost of structure. Many small social impact organizations operate on a tight budget, relying on volunteer labor and secondhand resources to provide services to vulnerable populations. However, this approach is not sustainable in the long run and hinders scalability as it underestimates the true cost of delivering social benefits. Understanding unit costs at various levels is essential for managing a budget effectively as an organization grows. For instance, a health clinic needs to know the cost of per patient, healthcare provider, and site before expanding to additional locations or cities. Calculating unit costs requires considerations of staff time allocation and ensuring that all expenses are included in the calculations. shared services costs, such as administrative departments, also need to be allocated accurately to understand the full cost of delivering social benefits. Strong cash flow. Many startup and high growth organizations prioritize cash flow over profitability for survival. Foundation grant assurances may not ease concerns for frontline workers struggling to pay bills. Bigger government contracts can also have delays with payments. Social entrepreneurs often sacrifice their pay during cash shortages. Planning ahead, securing lines of credit, and tapping into loan programs are crucial for managing cash flow. Mission-focused for-profit organizations can seek funding from private investors, venture funds, private equity firms, or corporate investors. Legal structure. The legal structure of an organization, whether for-profit, B-corporation, or non-profit, impacts the sources of funds available to it. Nonprofits are now earning revenue for services, similar to for-profit companies. Both types of organizations can receive government funding through grants or payments. Mission-focused for-profit companies may also receive support from philanthropy. New schools venture funds provide grants to for-profit and nonprofit education technology organizations. While large foundations can make mission-aligned investments, certain types of capital like venture funding are only available to companies with equity stakes. Social entrepreneurs organized as for-profits can access more capital for growth than nonprofits. Some organizations create multiple connected entities to maximize access to capital. Traditional labels may not accurately reflect an organization's profitability or financial stability. All organizations must manage resources wisely to achieve their mission regardless of their legal structure. Increasing scalability. Social sector leaders strive to envision a brighter future through their work. That vision usually requires an ever bigger reach for their organizations. However, achieving scalability is challenging for many initiatives, hindering their ability to make a significant impact on complex societal issues. Increasing scalability requires understanding whether an organization is ready for scale, figuring out a suitable approach to scaling, and configuring operations for scale. Readiness for scale. Before scaling a social impact organization, it is crucial to assess readiness by asking key questions. These include determining if the organization has earned the right to grow, managing costs effectively, having necessary conditions for success, funding growth, having the right people and leadership, and ensuring scalability of the organizational model. Both efficacy and financial sustainability must be strong before scaling to avoid quality problems and fiscal issues. Many social entrepreneurs believe expanding to new locations is the only way to increase their impact. But Jeffrey Bradach and Abe Grindle argue there are other methods for scaling. These include recruiting others to implement the solution, unbundling, field building, and policy advocacy. Kingmakers of Oakland started as a program in one school district and eventually developed a curriculum for other districts to replicate. To increase scale, social impact organizations must adapt their operations to reach more beneficiaries. Leaders should consider what drives their impact, whether it's a service, product, idea, and how much control is needed to achieve the desired benefit. Entrepreneurs may adjust their activities accordingly for scalability. Entrepreneurs have different approaches to scaling their organizations based on their control orientation. A service organization may choose to franchise or directly operate all its sites to scale. Success Academy, a charter management organization, grew significantly while maintaining academic excellence by tightly managing all aspects of its educational program. On the other hand, social entrepreneurs may opt for a network design for scaling, focusing on supporting other groups delivering similar services. Social impact organizations focusing on product or technology tools are inherently more scalable. Organizations may revise their products, streamline manufacturing processes, manage distribution, and provide user supports to increase scalability. Collaboration and partnerships among providers can also enhance scalability. For organizations focused on changing attitudes or behavior rather than delivering a product, communication and advocacy strategies are key to building scale. PATH, for example, worked to secure global adoption of heat-sensitive stickers on vaccine vials. Black Lives Matter has built a movement through independent actors with a shared purpose. Regardless of scaling model, organizations must ensure there is sufficient demand and applicability in the new context by building strong systems, culture, and support networks. Organizations can successfully scale their impact and reach more people with their services or products. Efficacy, sustainability, and scalability are interconnected concepts in social impact organizations. Increasing one may require sacrificing gains in another. Complex interventions may be highly effective, but simplifying them can enhance scalability. Expensive interventions are often less sustainable and scalable. Organizations reliant on philanthropy may prioritize new programs for funding, impacting the efficacy of core work. Establishing an earned revenue stream can lead to scope creep. Growth can decrease efficacy if management focuses on new markets over maintaining quality. The shift to remote operations during COVID highlighted both sacrifices and successes in efficacy. Leading a social sector organization involves balancing risks between efficacy, sustainability, and scalability, making trade-offs and finding strategies that reinforce each other. The difference between successful and less successful organizations is often the ability to mitigate the downside risk of actions that improve one dimension of the impact triangle but strain the other. As an example, the National Equity Project focuses on providing value through highly trained professionals, which has historically been challenging to scale. The organization's deliberate investment in maintaining the quality of the learning experience paid off during the COVID pandemic. as they were able to pivot to a virtual programming without losing the essence of participant experience. The experienced team creatively and purposely designed remote programs that fostered community, vulnerability, and authentic dialogue. The successful transition to virtual programs has allowed for expansion and financial sustainability while reaching a larger audience of educators. Sometimes there is no way to lessen the tension, and leaders must choose to prioritize one dimension of the impact triangle over another. In response to low college graduation rates among alumni, KIPP True College Program was created to provide better support. The program included networking college counseling, partnerships with supportive colleges, and increased outreach. Despite the $850 per alumnus cost and the need for additional fundraising, the investment paid off with a significant decrease in summer melt and a higher graduation rate for KIPP alumni. Summer melt is when students have been admitted to college but subsequently do not attend. Social entrepreneurs aim to create a mutual benefit among the three dimensions of the impact triangle, where an investment in one dimension also helps the others. Alder Graduate School of Education prioritized gaining approval to grant teacher credentials from the California Commission on Teacher Credentialing to create a virtuous cycle. This approval allowed teacher residents to secure FAFSA loans to pay tuition to Alder, whereas many teacher residency programs rely heavily on philanthropic subsidies to operate the core teacher training program. Alder GSE graduates could then almost double their income by becoming a fully credentialed teacher. School partners could provide a career pathway for their instructional aides and after-school staff and pay a living stipend to residents during their training period. Alder GSE was then able to focus philanthropic resources toward resident support and statewide expansion. For Alder GSE, securing this approval was the key to increasing efficacy, sustainability, and scalability. In many ways, many individuals, communities, and ecosystems, our world is better today than it was a few decades ago. In part because our leaders like Heather, Beth, and LaShawn, in the examples given in the book. At the same time, we still have too many suffering through indignities, injustices, and disasters, both natural and man-made. With their boundless creativity, social entrepreneurs can make a positive impact by creating effective and sustainable solutions. Thank you.